reality of Tai Chi is the much physical and spiritual health that it brings to its practitioners. But it's also very important to know that Tai Chi is a major part of Wushu. It was originally created as a martial art. Remember the Tai Chi and Yin Yang theory that we touched upon earlier? When this Tai Chi and Yin Yang theory was adopted into the application of martial arts and became a style, it was called Tai Chi Quan, or the fist of Tai Chi. Some are part of Wushu and also the martial art. The movements of Tai Chi have martial applications. Now, the movements of Tai Chi, they can seem so soft, nice, and gentle, and beautiful. So it can be quite amazing to a great many people that they actually have martial applications. Right? But they do. I'll give an example. For example, here.
The Tai Chi movement, that what we call wild horse parts is made. Right? So we go very nicely, very nice and slow. Right? You start with your hands, you get into your stance. Okay? But this has its martial application. Right? For example, say Shanghai's Hanshin here. Okay? Now, this is to block, and this is to throw. Okay? So,
soft to defeat hard. You can really use that or apply that in your everyday life, especially when you get into conflicts, right? Soften down, right? Learn to let it go, and learn to maybe find some other ways to deal with the situation. Learn to use the soft to defeat the hard. Okay, so those kind of things, as you can see. That's what made Tai Chi practice so fun, right? It's not just the physical practice, but as you get deeper and deeper into its theories and philosophies, you find it even more fun, right? Now, of this martial style, Bagua, was the I Ching, right? The Book of Changes. So that's why, Bagua has incorporated this concept of change from I Ching into its movements and techniques. And that's why we're practicing Bagua, right? We're constantly moving, turning, twisting, spinning, walking about. And